I think being a skateboarder, you look at things a different way. You know, like, people put cement all over the world. People made all this stuff out of cement. And it took, like Craig Stesic said, a bunch of kids on skateboards to figure out what to do with it, you know?
For me, skateboarding was the first inclination of creativity in my life.
This city for skateboarding is such a perfect setting. There are a lot of people that look at it and see wasteland, but I think that's, you know, as a skateboarder, and a lot of skateboarders see it, and they just see possibilities. But it's just a hotbed for creativity, and it's begging for all these things to happen. I think when you talk about building skate parks, it seems like such a no-brainer to a skateboarder that you'd want a skateboarder building it.
Starting from the day one, we showed them the spot and had them just like look around and soak it in.
I've known Mitch for a long time. We used to skate park. And I moved to California, came back here, and my friend's like, yeah, you know, like Mitch is doing this Powerhouse Productions. He's doing all this stuff to these houses in the neighborhood, like making them solar, taking them off the grid, planting gardens, just doing cool stuff for the neighborhood. So I would come down here and check it out, and then I just told him, I was like, hey Mitch, we should like try to build like a small little skate park.
The skate park, we've been thinking about this for a few years now, with the idea to really kind of make use of the empty landscape and to kind of use it as a hot spot where kids can go, keep them busy, keep them active.
He got the property, he got the permits, he got everything, and then I'm like, all right, now we need to start raising money. So, you know, we solicited some companies, Independent Trucks, Van Shoes, Spitfire, and then America jumped in.
The ride at Sculpture Park, this was already happening, but we came in and said, we're gonna do Wild on the Streets here. You know, we'll tell people about it, we'll raise some money, we'll do a benefit show. So it just kind of all came together.
But it was really in the spring that things just started clicking. The Goodwood fundraiser was a big one to kind of get everything gelled and that it was actually serious.
The art show did $25,000 and we got some grants, the companies came together, and then we had Timo and James and Albino and all these guys come out from Oregon. They drove their RV with their cement pumps and their compressors, and they drove across country, they got here. They were like, whoa, this is a crazy place. We've never been anything like this before. So I think they're really enjoying just like the hospitality and just, it's a unique place, you know?
Detroit rules, I love this place. Everybody's really cool. As long as you show people kindness, they show it back to you, you know? And it's a good vibration all over the city.
The neighbors are super happy because this whole field back here was full of garbage. And so even when the lot was just clean, the people were ecstatic.
Oh, I love it. Because keep my grandkids out of trouble.
It just Mitch's vision for this whole neighborhood and how Powerhouse works and buys these houses for $100 or $300, you know, the whole thing is pretty epic.
Gina and I moved here to live in an old storefront, an old Polish deli, and to use the storefront as our studio. But a couple years later, the foreclosure crisis started to really hit the neighborhood, and so we started to see a bit of abandonment. And we decided from there to buy a house, which is now the Powerhouse, that we've slowly been renovating it into an off-the-grid artist residency, art studio. And from there, we started recruiting people to move into the neighborhood, artists mainly, to buy houses, to renovate their own home, and to try to establish a sense of diversity, but also a sense of a more interesting neighborhood than what was happening at the time, which was sort of just people moving out. And then day two, we literally sat down with pad and paper and started working the park.
Mainly this phase of what we're doing now is just skatable, completely skatable surfaces, you know, structures, but more of the next phase is gonna be kind of a lot more art-oriented, I guess.
The overall concept is that it's sculptural in nature. Right now it seems it's a little more straightforward, but the overall landscape of the park would be sculptures, color, form, and light, and all things that you can skate and ride, but that if there's nobody riding it, or if it's just sitting there, it's actually a pretty interesting piece of art. And then day three, we started getting materials and started building templates, and for them to actually build something on this scale that was coming from our perspective, but also from their perspective as skaters, was really, I think, kind of amazing for them. And they went way bigger than we had expected, but it was just too good to pass up.
I know nothing about skateboarding until these guys came. For real. For these guys to come to Detroit, they come from all walks of life. These guys are the best white boy I ever fucked with.
If you build something, like, all these kids are gonna learn how to ride all this stuff, you know? And it's great, man. I think it's an awesome thing.
These are my homies.
Got love for you, baby.